we have Paul Willard. State your name and your address.
My name is Paul Willard. I live at 1457 South White Post Road, Bath, North Carolina, which is the White Post community. And I've come here tonight to alert the property owners of Beaufort County regarding big corporations sneaking in under the radar and building or constructing areas such as our great White Post solar field, which is within 100 feet of my front door. They did this without any respect or consideration for the White Post community, its property owners or residents, as we are taxpayers and most have lived in the area of Beaufort County all of our lives. I would like to take this time to ask County Commissioner, Beaufort County Commissioners, to take such action deemed necessary, which would make this impossible from happening again without having some sort of town meeting, community awareness alert, so it could notify our local residents and landowners to which it may affect. The damage is done pretty much to my property, and it will never be the same again. No matter what the outcome, Duke Renewables will never be able to replace the peace that we once had. This has decreased the value of my property, and if they are allowed to continue this mutilation of Beaufort County, this will devalue my property even more and other properties throughout Beaufort County. I feel due to the overall unknown health concerns and the unattractive looking glare which comes from the panels, a considerable distance should be studied and discussed in future proposed solar farms in residential areas. I would also like to take this time to add shame on the City of Washington and its electric department and its director, Keith Hart, for not being forthcoming with Beaufort County and its residents. But as I remembered, 99.9% who was in favor of this project are not residents of Beaufort County. And this comes from an earlier hearing with the North Carolina Utilities Commission held on April the 16th of this year. I would also like to thank Mr. Al Clem and Gary Brin for attending that hearing. Thank you for your time and consideration. I don't know if any of you are familiar, but I have a, have you seen it?
I have.
You've seen it.
Pass this around and you can take a look at that. And that was when it was not complete. It's not still not complete, but that was probably back in October.
That's your house there.
Yeah, that's my house right there, a little bit right there. This is where you can actually go online and see a whole bunch of pictures.
They're wasting any space, did they?
No.
Oh, how's that thing look at night?
Well, at night, no, you can't see anything at night.
Okay, there's no glare.
And you know, that's from today. If you come to my house in the afternoon, I'd say sometime right about now, you can't even sit in my front yard or on my front porch. The glare is so bad off of the panels when the sun starts to set. They said there's no glare off of the panels. But if you really want to see some glare, you come down about 5 or 6 o'clock and I'll show you all the glare you want to see. Basically, what they want to do is they want to totally put these solar farms all the way around all of my property. And that's when I decided that I needed to do something and take some action about this. It's not fair for me as a taxpayer to be totally pinned in. And from what I'm gathering, White Post is not the only community. There's a whole lot of other communities going to be involved in this as well. So basically what I'm asking is kind of the way I stated. We just need to be more aware. When I finally found out about this, I contacted Mr. Richardson. He had no aware. He was not aware of it at all. He checked around with some of the other commissioners, called me back in a day or two, said nobody else was aware. So this was something I feel like the county and its commissioners should have been aware of. And
Mr. Chairman, can I ask a question? When this project was started, Did they disclose to you exactly what it was going to be in relation to what you were to expect when they put it there? What were your expectations of what was going to happen?
Well, when they first started, I had no idea what they were doing because I didn't know what was happening over there. I kind of found out what was going on by accident. I just happened to go over one afternoon when they had stuck a truck in the ditch and it was raining. Asked them was there any way I could help them. And they said, well, unless you got a big tractor, probably not because we're stuck. And they were. I said, I don't have anything big enough. And the guy started, I finally asked him, I said, well, what are y'all really doing over there? The cotton was probably about that high at that time. And he said, well, and he began to tell me, he said, well, we're going to put a solar farm over here. And he was telling me how high they were going to be off the ground. It'd be about 7 foot off the ground. And he was just telling me some things about it. I said, okay. And that was pretty much all we talked about that afternoon. I went back over another afternoon. They were over there, and same guy was there, and he told me some more things about how it was going to look. And along the way, they made a lot of promises to me that what they were going to do, which has not been done. Nothing has been done at all. They were going to do some setbacks. They haven't done anything. They come just as close to the right of way as they could come. So I decided that when I found out about they going on the Millfield Road, which would have totally pinned my property in, I saw it in the newspaper, and I decided I need to make my move and go ahead and contact the Utilities Commission. I'm sorry I didn't do it in the beginning when the thing started back in September. I'm sorry I didn't do it then because I probably could have slowed that down a little bit and maybe got a little momentum going then, but that's, you know, hindsight.
Thank you.
But that's kind of where we're at.
Have you heard or have they told you when they're going to give you the results of the hearing?
We received a letter from the Utilities Commission, I believe it was last week, and they said we should be getting something by May the 30th this month. And as soon as I get it, I will make it available to you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Finish my comment. Mr. Earl Carney here.
Mr. Carney said he won't be able to make